If you suffer from migraines, you know they can be painful. It's estimated more than 39 million Americans deal with this. Today, a local doctor talking about which medications can help you. Joining us is Dr. Chad Domang, a local neurologist and partner at Cypress Point Pain Management. Thank you so much for joining us on this.
Absolutely. Good afternoon, Liz. Always a pleasure.
So what causes migraines? How are these symptoms different from a regular old headache?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the stats you said earlier, it's 15% worldwide. I mean, this is a major, major problem. The economic impact for the United States, they estimate anywhere from $5 to $17 billion a year of lost wages because of migraines. Migraines are a very specific type of headache. So it's a pounding headache. It's one side. You get sensitivity to light, nausea, vomiting. So it's related to a headache center in our brain, and it's a lot of genetic predispositions. So more common in women, related to hormone imbalances. So it's a very specific syndrome that's related to an abnormality of that part of our brain.
Yeah, I've worked with people who had it, and they literally could not function. Like a good friend of mine had to just go home. It was so bad.
Absolutely.
So what are the preventative medications to help? People want to know, what is it?
Yeah, so when we talk preventatives, just so our viewers understand, there's certain guidelines we look at that you want to put people on preventatives. You got to have a lot of headaches. So you got to be missing 2 or 3 days a week. You got to have at least one headache a week. And what I say with patients is, you know, do the risk of these medications justify you taking it every day to prevent headaches? So the four most common ones, the tried and true, is Topamax, Depakote, Amitriptyline, and Propranolol. Topamax and Depakote are kind of in the seizure prevention category. The big side effects of Topamax is you can have a little bit of confusion. You can get tingling in your mouth. You can lose weight. Depakote can make you gain weight. Propranolol, a lot of people may be familiar with that for blood pressure. It actually lowers blood pressure, and it can cause you to be tired or dizzy. And amitriptyline is an antidepressant. It can cause you to be sleepy, weight gain, dry mouth. But these are medicines you have to take every day to prevent the headaches from coming.
So what if these fail? What then do these patients do?
So two of the newer treatment options that have come around is Botox. I have some here. Botulinum toxin is derived from a bacteria. Clostridium botulinum is the name of the bacteria. Most people are familiar with Botox for cosmetics or muscle issues. The way that Botox works for migraines is not relaxing the muscles, but it reduces a lot of nasty neurotransmitters. We do injections very similar to cosmetics. We do injections in the forehead, back of the neck. You need to do this every 3 months for at least 9 months before you give it a try. Doing it once or twice, you really don't know if it works. The second one we're going to talk about is called a Movig. It's an injectable product. It hit the market probably about 4 or 5 years ago. This is interesting. You're going to like this, Liz. It is derived from a Chinese hamster ovarian cell. It is an antibody against a neurotransmitter called calcitonin gene-related peptide. This is an injectable product. It's once a month, but again, it's a preventative for headaches that are occurring all the time.
Well, hopefully they will work, because so many people will find these things just debilitating on a daily basis. So it's good that you're pointing this out. And can they get more information from you if this is something they'd want to pursue? Because a lot of times people want to know who to reach out to.
Yeah, you can contact me, social media, Facebook, contact my office, talk to your neurologist. I mean, these products have been around for a while, but you really need a relationship with a neurologist. You know, I did a lot of research looking at all this stuff, and there's good and bad about all this stuff. And these newer products are very expensive, so you need to make sure your insurance covers it. You need to make sure you understand the side effects, your underlying medical problems. It's very, you know, it's not a one-trick pony. You really need to sit down and understand what you're taking and why you're taking it.
Some really good advice there, especially for people who do suffer with this on a daily basis. Appreciate it, Dr. Chad. Have a great day.
Absolutely. Do I look younger with all this Botox next to me?
Do you even need Botox, Dr. Chad? I don't think so. Thank you so much.
Trust me.
Okay, appreciate it. Have a great day.